Ivyo, I welcome you to Irin TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Business Studies Form 2, Lesson Number 16. The topic it is communication. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. We start by looking at the lesson objectives. One, we are going to describe the lines of communication. Then we look at the essentials of effective communication. In our previous lesson, we managed to look at the vertical communication, where we said there is the downward communication and the vertical communication. Now, let us look at the second one, which is the horizontal communication. When we talk about the horizontal communication, it is between or among people of the same level. Rank. It can be used when, on circumstances when now the horizontal communication can be applied when coordinating and harmonizing different activities. When you are the coordinator of a certain organ activity, when you want to harmonize it, so you use horizontal communication. Number two, to create teamwork within the department. This is ensuring that there is that communication within the department. This one should be within the department. Number three, to exchange ideas in order to develop human resources. So you exchange your ideas within the same rank. You are able to exchange those ideas. So now you can be able to develop human resources. To reduce global brightness among different departments. So it is to ensure that in every department they can be able to think ahead. They can be able to see ahead. Then number five, to create sense of belonging among departmental heads. So you create that sense of belonging among the departmental heads, since they are the ones where now the information comes from. Thus acting as motivation factor. We look at the third one, which is the diagonal communication. The diagonal communication is between or among people of different levels in different departments or different organizations. The communication can either be formal or informal. So these are totally different departments that need to communicate. Now, how do they communicate? It is either through formal. This is where now they use messages using the approved and recognized way in an organization. And the informal. Informal is communication which is neither in the right form nor follows the right channels. So it is not in the right form and it does not follow the right channels, but there is the passing of information. Now, we get to look at the essentials of effective communication. Now, communication is a process that involves the interchange of information and ideas between two or more people. For communication to be effective, it must be originated. It must have an origin. It must be produced. It must be transmitted. It must be received. It must be understood. And it must be acted upon. So that is the reason as to why we are saying for any communication to be effective, if at all you are passing information, for it now to be authentic, for it now to be received, so there must be the source. Where is it coming from? Origin. It must be produced. It must be transmitted. That is passing from one person. It must be received by the recipient. Then understood. Clearly understood, then acted upon. Now, When we talk about the essentials of the effective communication, they are the sender. We must have the sender element, the sender. This is the communicator. Or where this is the originality of the information. The sender is the person who has the original message. Who is the origin of the message? Then there must be that message. Whatever that is being read, there must be the media, the channel. What am I going to use in order for me to pass the message? Is it a message? Is it phone calls? Are they memos? So the channel, the medium must be there. Then the receiver, the person you're sending the message to, the receiver, somebody is receiving the message. Then the feedback, acting upon the message you have received. But the process of effective communication has 7 steps. So it has 7 steps. Effective communication has 7 steps. 1, sender. Sender must get the information ready. Message. You send the message. You encode that message. After encoding, you use the channel. After using that channel, there is the receiver on the other side. He is going to decode the message. After decoding, you need to get the feedback. So that is the reason as to why we say there are 7 steps. Naming sender. This sender must have the message. He must or she must encode the message. He must use a medium, that is the channel. The receiver must be there. He or she must receive the information and decode about it, then get the feedback. Activity. Explain the main essential elements of effective communication. For reference, you can get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. In case you have any question, you can get us either through the SMS, through the YouTube, through the Facebook, or you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Elim TV. Thank you.